After being shunted out because of an explosive report on the alleged special treatment given to former AIADMK leader Sasikala, IPS officer D Roopa has now been served a legal notice by former DGP Prisons HN Satyanarayana Rao. D Roopa now joins us on Mirror Now. Also with us is Faye D'Souza, executive editor of the channel. Faye?
Well, Kavita, this is obviously an important story because it's a story against corruption, in our jails, and the continuing narrative of people who call out corruption, people who expose corruption, being silenced in our country on a regular basis. I understand that the former DGP Prisons has demanded an apology from D Roopa. D Roopa joins us right now. I want to first thank you, Roopa, for coming out and speaking with us this evening, and also for the bravery that you have displayed through this entire incident. There are two challenges of court cases. The first one from Mr. Rao, the former DIG Prisons, who has asked you to apologize, and if you don't apologize, face civil and criminal action against you to the tune of 50 crore rupees. What is your reaction to this notice that you have received?
I have done my duty. I have acted in a manner transparent and accountable, which all government servants are supposed to. And I have put this in the report about the irregularities that existed in the prison. I have heard today his advocate speaking. And he has said that he also agrees that the irregularities existed. Now, if irregularities existed, that is what exactly I reported in my report. And instead of standing by me, instead of setting right the irregularities, he sending me memos, notices, defamation notice, etc., speak for itself on which side he is. And this I've done as a part of my duty. And I will, all the other things that his lawyer has said are factually wrong. And I will appear in the court myself. I'll stand myself in the court and defend and also prove the things in the court.
Well, Roopa, there was also a challenge of the fact that he said that if you took photographs of other jails, other parts of the jail, why weren't you able to take photographs of the kitchen that you had mentioned in your report where Sasikala was being provided with special food, or she was being provided with special amenities? What's your response to that allegation?
I could not understand your question, but I have already submitted the report, and it has evidences mentioned in the report, and there is enough evidence. Inquiry is on, let it continue. And other things that which are, I'm sure with the inquiry, truth will be revealed. And about his advocate speaking today, I also got to know whatever other things he has said about photos and such things. I wouldn't like to elaborate on this really, and what he has said is factually wrong, and I will prove it in the court.
Well, Roopa, you've also...
Thank you.
Okay, very quick question. If you're still with us, Roopa, you've also been reprimanded for speaking to the press in the past and for voicing your opinion. Is this a reaction from you that you will continue to speak to the press? The Chief Minister of Karnataka also said that officers should not be leaking reports to the media.
What was your first part of the question?
So my first part of the question is why...
I heard the last part about the media thing.
Yes.
Let me... Okay.
Yes, go ahead.
Let me say in brief that I have not violated conduct rules. Conduct rules themselves have now been amended with the words transparent and accountability being included in that. And I have Supreme Court rulings also to one in 2014. In a similar case, which said that there's no misconduct in this kind of a case, similar as mine. And I have not violated any conduct rules. This is what I would like to say.
Roopa, very, very quick question. There were news reports of 30 convicts being moved out of that jail. All right, she seems to have left. That was D Roopa there speaking to us about how she is standing by her report, standing by everything that she presented in her report. She will, she says, after having done her duty, she will stand up in court in that same manner and defend every part of her report. She says she has enough evidence. She is not afraid of being dragged into court, and she will reveal the truth. So obviously, threats that have come in from the TTV, Dinakaran faction, and from the former DIG prisons, HN Satyanarayan Rao, are not intimidating her. She is a strong, powerful woman who stands by what she says. And she says that she's not afraid of any of this, any of the pressure, the political pressure, she might be receiving right now from her seniors as well. She said she's ready for her day in court.
Right, Faye. Also, we do know that the DGP prisons is also nearing his retirement. He's expected to retire on the 31st of July. Do you think that is also one of the reasons which has prompted him to threaten Roopa, D Roopa over here with a civil and a criminal defamation suit?
Well, Kavita, there's a pattern that we're seeing right now. Whenever there is, an individual in any way who calls out corruption, who points out corruption, they receive these sort of threats. We also understand now that the family of Kanchan Nath, who died because of that coconut tree that fell on her, are receiving threats as well from factions of political parties who are telling them that, listen, you have to live in this city. I wouldn't make a fuss about it and file a complaint if I were you. So there seems to be a pattern right now of people being silenced, intimidated, threatened with defamation. We saw it happen to RJ Malishka as well. And it is women like Malishka, women like D Roopa who are standing up right now and saying that they will not be threatened. That they, that we have the right in this country to do our duty. We have the right to voice our opinion. And specifically in D Roopa's case, because she's a functioning police officer, she keeps saying that she has done her duty, that she has not broken any of the rules. And the fact that today she says she is waiting for her day in court, she's going to stand up in court because she has the evidence. She's obviously convinced that the truth is on her side. And that is, those are the traits of someone who is convinced with what they have as evidence, who is convinced that their day in court will actually prove them to be on the right side of the truth. And I think that's a very heartening sign.
Yes, Faye. And of course, on Mirror Now, we will continue championing those who stand by the truth. Thank you for getting us your perspective over there.